ज्ञानत लब्धे सर्वम। अ वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू यू स्टूडेंट्स। टुडे वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट एक्सरसाइज 2.2। फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन ऑफ द एक्सरसाइज इज फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ पॉलिनोमियल 5x माइनस 4x स्क्वायर प्लस 3 एट x इक्वल्स टू 0। मीन्स व्हाट वी हैव टू डू, वी हैव टू सब्स्टिट्यूट द वैल्यू ऑफ द वेरिएबल x एज 0 एंड देन ऑन सब्स्टिट्यूटिंग वैल्यू ऑफ द वेरिएबल व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ द पॉलिनोमियल वी विल बी गेटिंग। दिस इज व्हाट वी नीड टू फाइंड आउट। सो पॉलिनोमियल गिवन टू अस इज 5x माइनस ऑफ 4x स्क्वायर प्लस ऑफ 3। नाउ वी नीड टू फाइंड आउट द वैल्यू ऑफ द पॉलिनोमियल एट x इक्वल्स टू 0। मीन्स वी नीड टू फाइंड आउट P0। P0 इज व्हाट? इट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ द पॉलिनोमियल एट x इक्वल्स टू 0। सो वी विल बी सब्स्टिट्यूटिंग द वैल्यू ऑफ x एज 0 इन ऑल द प्लेसेस। सो इट बिकम्स 5x बिकम्स 5 टाइम्स ऑफ 0 माइनस 4x स्क्वायर विल बिकम 4 टाइम्स ऑफ 0 स्क्वायर प्लस ऑफ 3। सो हेयर 5 टाइम्स ऑफ 0 इज 0 माइनस 0 स्क्वायर इज 0, 0 टाइम्स ऑफ 4 इज अगेन 0 प्लस ऑफ 3। सो द वैल्यू ऑफ पॉलिनोमियल एट x इक्वल्स टू 0 इक्वल्स टू प्लस 3। अंडरस्टूड? सिमिलरली इन द सेकेंड पार्ट we have to substitute the value of x equals to minus 1. Now again we'll start with the polynomial px given as 5x minus of 4x square plus of 3. So now since we have to find out the value of the polynomial at x equals to minus 1, that will be written as p minus 1. So p minus 1 will be 5 times of minus 1 minus of 4 times of square of minus 1 plus of 3. So it will be 5 times of minus 1 will be minus of 5, square of minus 1 is plus 1, plus 1 into minus 4 is minus 4 plus of 3. So it will be plus minus 5 minus 4 is minus of 9 plus of 3. So that means the value of polynomial at x equals to minus 1 is equal to minus 9 plus 3, that is equal to minus of 6. Okay. Now the same polynomial, we have to find out the value of the same polynomial at x equals to 2. So again we will be substituting the value of polynomial as 2 here. So it becomes 5 times of 2 minus 4 times of 2 square plus of 3. So 5 times of 2 is 10 minus of 2 square is 4, 4 into 4 is 16 plus of 3. Plus of 10 plus of 3 is plus 13 minus of 16 plus 13 minus 16 is minus 3. So the value of the polynomial at x equals to 2 is minus 3. I hope the question is clear to you. Second question is also same, just the language of the question is different. There they were saying find the value of the polynomial. Here instead of writing value of polynomial, they have written find P0, P1 and P2 of the given polynomial Py. So we know that P0 is what? P0 is the value of the polynomial at the variable y equals to 0. So we will be finding P0, that will be P0, that is the value of polynomial Py at y equals to 0. P0 equals to 0 square. Instead of y we will be replacing y as 0, so y square becomes 0 square minus of 0 plus of 1. Square of 0 is 0 minus 0 plus 1. So the value of P0 is equal to 1. Now similarly if we calculate P1, so P1 will be square of 1 minus of 1 plus of 1. So square of 1 is 1 minus 1 plus 1. it will be equal to 1 minus 1 is 0, 0 plus 1 is 1. So the value of P1 is equal to 1. Now we have to find out P2. So P2 is equal to square of 2 minus of 2 plus of 1. So square of 2 is 4 minus 2 plus 1, 4 plus 1 is 5, 5 minus 2 is 3. So the value of P2 is 3. I hope it is clear. Okay. Similarly, the second part is PT. We have to find out the value P0, P1 and P2 for the polynomial PT, where PT is equal to 2 plus T plus 2T square minus T cube. So the very similar as we have done the above part, we will be substituting the values of the variable T first as 0. On substituting PT as T as 0, we get 2 plus 0 plus 2 times of 0 square minus of 0 cube. So it will be 2 plus 0 plus 0 square is 0 times of 2 is 0 minus of 0. That means the value of P0 is equal to 2 only. Now P1 is equal to 2 plus, in place of T will be putting 1, plus 2 times of square of 1 minus of 1 cube. So it will be 2 plus 1 plus of 1 square is 1, 1 times of 2 is 2 minus of 1. So 2 plus 2, 4 plus 1, 5, 5 minus of 1. So the value of P1 is equal to 4. Similarly, if we have to calculate the value P2, so P2 will be equal to 2 plus 2 plus 2 times of 2 square minus of 2 cube. So it will be 2 plus 2 plus 2 square is 4, 4 times of 2 is 8 minus 8. So plus 8 minus 8 will cancel out. So P2 is also equal to 4. So the value of the given polynomial at t equals to 0, that is P0, is coming out to be 2. The value of the polynomial at t equals to 1, that is P1, equals to 4. And the value of the polynomial at t equals to 2, that is P2, is also equal to 4. Now we have to calculate the value of the polynomial Px equals to x cube at P0. So at P0, it will be cube of 0. Cube of 0 is 0 only. The value of P0 is 0. P1 will be cube of 1. Cube of 1 is 1 only. And P2, that is cube of 2, that is equal to, P2 is equal to 8. Okay. Similarly, now the fourth part. Part number fourth. That is what? Px equals to x minus 1, x plus 1. Now again, we need to find out the value. That is P0. So P0 will be 0 minus 1 into 0 plus 1. 0 minus 1 is minus 1 multiplied by 0 plus 1 is plus 1. Minus 1 into plus 1, that is P0 equals to minus of 1. Now P1 equals to, again in place of x we will be putting 1. So 1 minus 1 into 1 plus of 1. So 1 minus 1 is 0, 0 times of 2, that is equal to 0 only. So we get the value of P1 as 0. Now if we say P2, then P2 is equal to 2 minus 1, x is equal to 2, and 2 plus 1. So it will be 2 minus 1 is 1 times of 3. So 1 times of 3 is 3. So the value of P2 is equal to 3. Okay? I hope this is understood. Question number 3 is saying, verify, we have to test whether the following are zeros of polynomial. Like here, we are given up in the first part, part number 1, we are given up the polynomial is 3x plus 1. Polynomial is 3x plus 1 and the value of 0 is minus 1 by 3. So x, if on substituting x as minus 1 by 3, if the value of the polynomial px becomes equal to 0, then we say that minus 1 by 3 is the 0 of polynomial. Otherwise, if on substituting minus 1 by 3, the value of the variable is not coming equal to 0, then we say that minus 1 by 3 is not the 0 of polynomial. So we'll test whether it is the polynomial or not. Let's see. So for substituting the or for finding the polynomial px at x equals to minus 1 by 3, we write it as p minus 1 by 3. So p minus 1 by 3 is equal to 3 times of x, the value of x is minus 1 by 3, plus of 1. So this 3 and 3 will cancel out. So we get minus 1 plus of 1. So yes, p minus 1 by 3 is coming equal to 0. So since the value of p minus 1 by 3 is coming equal to 0, we say that what can be said about minus 1 by 3? Yes, we can say that minus 1 by 3 is the 0 of polynomial. Since we know that 3x plus 1, one more thing we can say from here, that 3x plus 1 is a binomial, means a polynomial with two terms, and it is a linear polynomial, means a polynomial with degree equal to 1. So if the degree is equal to 1, we know that number of zeros is equal to the degree of the polynomial. Since the degree of the given polynomial is 1, that is, it is a linear polynomial, so it will have only one zero, isn't it? So yes, we can say that minus 1 by 3 is the 0 of the polynomial. Now in the second part, we are given up with the polynomial px equals to 5x minus 5. We need to verify whether 4 upon 5 is the 0 of the given polynomial or not. So similar way as we have done in the first part, we will substitute the value of the variable x as 4 by 5. And if on substituting the value of the variable, the value of the polynomial is equal to, if on substituting the value is coming equal to 0, then we say that the given polynomial is coming equal to 0, then we say that 4 by 5 is the 0 of the polynomial. So let's see, on substituting 4 by 5, we get the polynomial px at x equals to 4 by 5 will be 5 times of x, that is 5 times of 4 by 5 minus of 5. So 5 and 5 will cancel out, it will be 4 minus 5. So very clearly you can see from here that the value of the polynomial is not equal to 0. If the value of the polynomial, that is px or p 4 by 5, is not equal to 0, since p 4 upon 5 is not equal to 0, therefore we say that 4 upon 5 is not the 0 of polynomial 5x minus 5. Understood? Okay, so we will be doing the third part. Okay, so in the third part we are having the polynomial px equals to x square minus 1. It is a quadratic polynomial. Now we have to check whether 1 and minus 1 are the zeros of this polynomial or not. Remember, I have already told you
that in a quadratic polynomial there are two zeros. So first, if we substitute the value of the variable x equal to 1, so we get polynomial px, that is p x equals to 1 will be p1. It will be equals to square of 1. In place of x, I have substituted the x equals to 1 minus of 1. That is square of 1 is 1, 1 minus 1 is 0. That means p1 is equal to 0. So yes, 1 is the 0 of the given polynomial. Now the second part, so 1 is the 0 of x square minus 1. Similarly, now we have to test minus 1 is the 0 or not. So we will find out the value of p minus 1. So p minus 1 equals to, we'll substitute the value of x as minus 1. So x square become square of minus 1 and then minus of 1. Square of minus 1 is plus 1. Plus 1 minus of 1, that is again coming equal to 0. That means minus 1 is the 0 of the polynomial x square minus 1. So in this case, both 1 and minus 1 are the zeros of the given quadratic polynomial x square minus 1. Now similarly, in the next part, we are having a polynomial x plus 1 into x minus 2. If we solve this, we will get a quadratic polynomial. So yes, it is a quadratic polynomial, but we need not to solve it. We just need to check whether minus 1 and 2 are the zeros of the polynomial or not. So first of all, we will calculate the value of p minus 1. So p minus 1 will be x plus 1 will become minus 1 plus of 1, and x minus 2 will become minus 1 minus of 2. So minus 1 plus of 1 is 0, 0 times of minus 3. So yes, p minus 1 is equal to 0. So that means minus 1 is the 0 of x square, 0 of the polynomial x plus 1 and x minus 2. Similarly, we have to find the other number also, that is 2. So we will find out the value of p2. So p2 will be what? X will be substituted by 2, so it will become 2 plus 1, and here x minus 2 will become 2 minus 2. Again, 2 plus 1 is 3 times of 2 minus 2, that is 0. Again, the value of p2 is equal to 0. So since the value of p2 is equal to 0, we say that yes, 2 is also the 0 of polynomial x plus 1 and x minus 2. Both minus 1 and plus 2 are the zeros of the given polynomial. Now in the fifth part, we need to check the polynomial is given px equals to x square, and we need to test whether x equals to 0 is the 0 of the given polynomial or not. So we will be finding the value of p0. So p0 will be 0 square. So that is equal to 0 only. So we say that yes, 0 is the 0 of polynomial x square. So now the next part, that is the sixth part, px, polynomial px equals to lx plus m, where l and m are the constants, and we have to check whether minus m upon l is the 0 of the polynomial. So we will write here p within bracket minus m upon l. So it will be equal to lx, that is substituting the value of x as minus m upon l plus of m. So plus of l and minus of m will cancel out. This will cancel out. So what we get? We get value minus m plus of m. Minus m plus of m is 0. That means the value of p minus m upon l is 0. So we say that minus m upon l is the 0 of the polynomial lx plus m. In this question also, we need to find out whether minus 1 by under root 3 is the 0 of the polynomial 3x square minus 1. So this is a quadratic polynomial, so it will certainly have two zeros, but first we will check whether minus 1 by root 3 is the 0 or not. So we will find the value of polynomial px at x equals to minus 1 by root 3, that is p minus 1 by root 3. So that will be equals to substituting the value of x equals to minus 1 upon root 3. So 3 times of minus 1 upon under root 3 whole square minus of 1. So it will be 3 times of square of minus 1 will be plus 1 and square of root 3 will be 3 minus of 1. Again this will be cancelled out. Plus 3 and minus 3 will be cancelled out. Remember children, this can be cancelled out because it is one term. But if something is here, it cannot be cancelled from here because there is a minus sign in between. Okay. So it will be 1 minus of 1, that is equals to 0. So the value of p minus 1 by root 3 is equals to 0. So yes, minus 1 by root 3 is the 0 of the given polynomial. So we say that minus 1 upon under root 3 is 0 of the polynomial 3x square minus 1. Now let us check about the second value, that is 2 upon root 3. So substituting the value of x as 2 upon root 3, so we get 3 times of 2 upon root 3 square minus of 1. So it will be 3 times of square of 2 is 4, square of root 3 is again 3 minus of 1. So this 3 and this 3 will cancel out. We get the value as 4 minus 1. That is the value of p 2 upon root 3 is coming equal to 3. That is not equal to 0. So we say that 2 upon root 3 is not the 0 of 3x square minus 1. So the first one, that is minus 1 upon root 3, is the 0 of 3x square minus 1, but 2 upon root 3 is not the 0 of 3x square minus 1, since the value of p 2 upon root 3 is not coming equal to 0. Okay, so here we need to find whether 1 upon 2 is the 0 of the given polynomial or not. So px, the polynomial is given 2x plus 1. So we will be finding p 1 upon 2. So p 1 upon 2 will become 2x will become 2 times of 1 upon 2 plus of 1. So that will be 2 times of 1 upon 2 will be 1. 1 plus 1 equals to 2. So obviously we say that since the value of p 1 by 2 is not coming equal to 0, we say that 1 by 2 is not the 0 of polynomial 2x plus 1. Now in question number 4, we have to find the 0 of polynomial. We are given up with the linear polynomial and we have to find the 0 of polynomial. So we know that for finding the 0 of polynomial, we will be equating the given polynomial equal to 0. So here x plus 5 is the given polynomial. We will say that for finding 0 polynomial, we will take the value of px equals to 0. That means the value of x plus 5 will become equals to 0. So x will be equal to minus 5. So minus 5 is the 0 of polynomial x plus 5. I suppose it is clear. For finding 0 of any polynomial, we have to equate that polynomial equals to 0, and for a linear polynomial we are doing this. So we will get the value of the given 0 of the given linear polynomial. Now we come to the second part. So here the value of polynomial is given x minus 5. So again we will do the same thing. We will equate the polynomial equals to 0. That means the x minus 5 will become equals to 0. So x will be equals to plus 5. So 5 is the 0 of the polynomial x minus 5. I suppose this is clear. Similarly, in the third part, we will equate the polynomial px equals to 0. 2x plus 5 becomes equals to 0. Then 2x will become equals to minus of 5 transposition. So x will be minus 5 upon 2. So the minus 5 upon 2 is the 0 of the polynomial two x plus 5. Okay, I suppose it is clear now. So very similar part, 3x minus 2, as we have done in the previous part. Similarly, here also we will equate the value of the polynomial equals to 0. So in that case, 3x minus 2 become equals to 0. 3x will be equals to plus of 2. X will be equals to 2 by 3. So 2 by 3 is the 0 of the given polynomial 3x minus 2. Now the next part, that is px equals to 3x. So here also the same process will be repeated. We will equate the polynomial equals to 0. Then in that case, 3x will become equals to 0. X will be equal to 0 upon 3. And 0 upon 3 is again equals to 0 only. That means the value, what will be the 0 of the polynomial? 0 is the 0 of the polynomial 3x. Okay. In all these cases, I suppose it is clear now, that all the cases, since the highest power of the variable is 1 only, that is degree of all these polynomial is 1 only, so they all will have only 1 0. In the next part, polynomial is given equals to ax, where a is not equal to 0. A is a constant, but it is not equal to 0, because if the constant becomes equals to 0, 0 times of x, then px will become equals to 0. Okay, it will become a zero polynomial, but here we are discussing about the linear polynomial. Okay, so again the same process, px will become equals to 0, then ax will be equals to 0, x will be equals to 0 upon a, that is 0 divided by any number will be always 0. So x will be equals to 0, that is 0 is the 0 of polynomial 0 is the 0 of polynomial ax. Okay. In the last part also, px equals to cx plus d, where c and d are the constant and the value of c is not equal to 0. If the value of c is equal to 0, then it won't be a linear polynomial. That's why it is given that c is not equal to 0. C and d are constant and the value of constant can be any real number. Now same process will be repeated. We will equate the polynomial equals to 0. That means cx plus d will be equals to 0. Then cx will be equals to minus of d. X will be equals to minus of d upon c. That means what is the 0? Minus d by c is the 0 of polynomial 3x plus d. I suppose the concept is clear now. You can practice few more questions based on this. I hope now it must be clear what is a zero polynomial and how to calculate the zero of a polynomial. And for in case of linear polynomial, we will have only one zero. In case of quadratic polynomial, we will have two zeros and so on. So thank you so much, class. Next class, we will be introducing the remainder theorem.